This tutorial will show you how to use the Seagate DiskWizard application to utilize the full capacity of a 3 terabyte or larger drive in a Windows 7 and a Windows 8 operating system. After installing a hard drive with more than 2 terabytes of storage capacity in a system without a UEFI BIOS, your drive's partition will look similar to the one shown in this representation of the Windows Disk Management screen. You may have a reserved partition. Your C volume will contain up to 2 terabytes of partitioned storage space, and the remaining portion of the drive's capacity will be unallocated and unpartitioned. This video will illustrate how to use DiskWizard's disk management utilities to allocate, partition, and format the extended capacity of your drive. To begin, launch DiskWizard. After DiskWizard opens, scroll to the lower portion of the page. Navigate to the Disk Management section and click on the Seagate Extended Capacity Manager link. After the Extended Capacity Manager opens, you will see a graphical representation of your drive's native capacity and the extended unallocated storage space. To begin the process of preparing the unallocated storage space so that it can be partitioned and formatted, click on the Apply button. The system will prepare the unallocated space and install a device driver that will support the extended capacity. This process takes only a few moments to complete. When the process is finished, click on the Close button. The Extended Capacity Manager will close and you will return to the DiskWizard main menu. The next step is to partition, format, and set the drive letter for the extended capacity of the drive. To continue, click on the Add New Disk link in the Disk Management section of the page. The Add New DiskWizard will launch. To continue, click on the Not Initialized Extended Capacity Disk with the AVD designation prefixing the drive's model number to select it. Then click Next. On the Initialization Options page, you will be required to select an initialization method. The MBR layout, which is the default for Windows XP and Vista, will support a partition size of up to 2 terabytes. If the extended capacity of your drive is larger than 2 terabytes, and you select the MBR layout, the maximum partition size will be limited to 2 terabytes and any remaining capacity will be unused. The GPT layout will support larger partitions. However, this option will only be available for Windows 7 and Windows 8 systems. To continue, select the type of initialization layout you want to use by clicking on that method's radio button. Then click Next. The next step is to define the new partition's settings and to partition and format the unallocated storage space of the drive. To begin the partitioning process, first double-click on the gray status bar. The Partition Settings dialog box will open. You may use either the drop-down boxes or the slider bar to create more than one partition. However, in this tutorial, we will make the remaining drive capacity a single partition. Make sure that the file system type and the partition letter are correct for your system. Then enter a name for the new partition. After you have configured your partition and created a label, click on the Accept button to continue. On the Create Partitions page, you will see a graphical representation of the new partition's layout. If you wish, you may click on the Cancel button to return to the Partition Settings page and modify the partition layout. Click Next to continue. On the Summary page, you will be provided with a before and after comparison of the new partition. When you are satisfied with the partition layout, click Proceed to begin the partitioning process. You will be able to view the partitioning process as it occurs, and you will be notified when the operation has been completed. Click the OK button to finalize the process. These are all the steps required to use the DiskWizard's disk management utilities to allocate, partition, and format the extended capacity of your drive. This illustration shows the Windows disk management view of the hard drive storage in the system after DiskWizard's disk management has added the device driver support. Disk 0 and Disk 1 is the same physical device. Disk 0's 2 terabyte partition is supported by the operating system. Disk 1's 1 terabyte partition is supported by a device driver. The device driver causes the partition on Disk 1 to be represented as a second drive by the operating system. However, you may access and use this drive just as you would any other hard drive connected to your computer. This concludes the DiskWizard Extended Capacity Support tutorial. For more information on Seagate DiskWizard, please see the rest of the DiskWizard tutorials.
Thank you.